صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. ثم أما بعد، ذكر الإمام النووي رحمه الله تعالى في كتابه رياض الصالحين باب فضل الزهد في الدنيا Excellence of Ascetic Life. كان ابن عمر رضي الله عنهما يقول: إذا أمسيت فلا تنتظر الصباح، وإذا أصبحت فلا تنتظر المساء، وخذ من صحتك لمرضك ومن حياتك لموتك. رواه البخاري. So ابن عمر رضي الله عنهما used to say, it's not the Prophet says, ابن عمر used to say, when you survive till the evening, do not expect to live until the morning. And when you survive until the morning, do not expect to live until the evening. Do good deeds when you are in good health before you fall sick, and do good deeds as long as you are alive before death strikes. Allah. What a beautiful advice from Sayyidina Ibn Umar رضي الله عنهما. Which means, alhamdulillah, right now we're at night, at evening, right? Do the best that you can do. And do not expect that you're going to be alive tomorrow, subhanAllah. No one guarantee that, no matter if you're healthy, if you're safe, subhanAllah. مَا بَيْنَ طَرْفَةِ عَيْنٍ وَانْتِبَاهَتِهَا يُبَدِّلُ اللَّهُ مِنْ حَالٍ إِلَى حَالٍ. It's just take blink of eye, and then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will change the whole thing. And for those who might experience accident or something like this, they said, oh, I was okay, and all of a sudden something happened, I don't know what happened, right? So it's like this, subhanAllah. But when the appointed time will come, the death will come, it's the end. We might experience a car accident or any accidents, and alhamdulillah, we're still alive, right? We're still good and we're still moving on. But when the death strikes, that's it. So, إذا أمسيت فلا تنتظر الصباح وإذا أصبحت فلا تنتظر المساء. Tomorrow morning, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wrote for you that you're going to be amongst the living people, so Allah a'lam if you're going to make it to evening or not. Allah a'lam. So do your best. As well, خذ من صحتك لمرضك. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, alhamdulillah, blessed you with a good health. Take advantage of this and do as much as you can. Before, you will not be able to do. And I remember this point, it's so, يعني, ما عذر من بلغ العشرين إن هجعت عيناه أو عاقه عن طاعة كسل. What's the excuse for someone who is 20 to sleep and he is lazy to do a good deed? He's 20. So what's his excuse? SubhanAllah. What about someone who's 80, 90? This one, he might be not lazy, I'm going to say he's tired because of the health. Or he will sleep at night because he's old, subhanAllah. But someone who is healthy and he's 20, no excuse for him to spend the whole night sleeping. He should have a portion for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to pray to make dua. And no excuse for him as well to be lazy, not doing and not taking advantage of his time and his health, subhanAllah. So, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide us all. Ameen, ameen, ameen. Salli Allahumma ala Nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. InshaAllah, tomorrow, as you all know, the first day or the first 10 days, inshaAllah, is the best 10 days in the year. The whole year, those are the best 10 days. So let's show Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala our sincere ibadah as much as we can. Absolutely, we could have the intention, inshaAllah, to fast tomorrow, and the intention to fast the whole 9 days as much as we can. I know it's a little bit long, the day, but it's worth it, inshaAllah ta'ala. So adjust your alarm to pray to rak'ah before Fajr, and then have sahur, and then inshaAllah you'll be fasting. Tomorrow, be busy with the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and as we mentioned, fasting, remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, establishing the salah the right way, do extra salawat, and then donation as much as you can. Donate from your time, from your health, so help your people around you at home, your mother, your wife, whatever. Donate from your health that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant you. Many other things, salatul arham, call your parents, call your kinship to make sure that they're good, they're fine, your health is okay, and actually congratulate them with these blessed days. Many, many other things that you can do, recitation of the Quran, reflection, bringing joy to your kids, to your family, happening, making them happy. All of these things, inshallah, will count it as a way and good deeds, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will, inshallah, reward you for this. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to support us and help us to worship Him the best way that pleases Him. Allahumma inna ala dhikrika wa shukrika wa husna ibadatik. على الوجه الذي يدرك عنا يا كريم امين امين وصلي اللهم على نبينا محمد وعلى اله وصحبه وسلم الحمد لله.